Hello all, welcome. This is Abhisha Malar, doing my first year MBA at Savita School of Management. I am here to share a small gist about this week's news briefing. Starting up with the headlines, Reliance Jio smartphone may have little impact on tariff, says expert. Raising production, reviving existing fields can multiply gains for ONGC. Data breach in trading platform has put millions of customers at risk. New rules for e-commerce companies likely to raise compliance burden. Bharat Biotech Covaxin shows over 77% efficacy in phase 3 trials. Starting up with a briefing of these headlines, Reliance Jio smartphone may have little impact on tariff, says expert. On Thursday, Reliance Jio said it would launch JioPhone Next, a smartphone developed in partnership with Google. Expert says the move is expected to have little impact on tariff but will propel a smoother and faster transition to 5G. Raising production, reviving existing fields can multiply gains for ONGC. India's largest oil producer, ONGC, declared Q4 results, reflecting the rise in global energy prices. The standalone results were not taken into account. ONGC majority shareholding in HPCL increased due to buyback offer on a consolidated basis. ONGC recorded revenue from operations of ₹1.14 trillion in 2020-21. Which was 9.6% higher than ₹1.04 trillion a year. Data breach in trading platform has put millions of customers at risk. The customers' data has been put for a sale on a data sharing platform on June 15th, and this incident has been reported to CERT by Technisent. The founder and CEO Technisent said that such incidents raises the possibility of financial frauds among Indians. He also added that the lack of data security authority in India has resulted in a massive increase in the number of such cases and it puts customers at risk. The new rules for e-commerce companies likely to raise compliance burden. The new e-commerce rules as proposed in the Ministry of Consumer Affairs will impact a wide range of companies including Swiggy, Zomato and Big Basket. Government officials said taxi aggregators such as Ola and Uber, food aggregators such as Zomato and Swiggy, online aggregators such as Big Basket will fall under the ambit of the proposed consumer protection rules. Bharat Biotech Covaxin shows over 77% efficacy in phase 3 trials. The vaccine has shown an efficacy rate of 93% against severe disease and 60% against asymptomatic COVID-19. Bharat Biotech has noted on its website that Covaxin demonstrated 78% vaccine efficacy against mild, moderate and severe COVID-19 diseases. That's all about the news briefing of this week. This is Abhishek Malar signing off. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.